Hello. Hi. Now we are going to see some few more problems in current division rule. Already I have taken what is current division rule and how you have to derive the formula and all. If you are not clear with your formula, you just go and recall about the current division rule. Just see my previous videos about the current division and voltage division rules, so that it will be easy to derive the formula for the current division rule. We are going to see some 3 or 4 problems in the current division rule, so that it will be very clear. This is the 25th problem which we are seeing here. Find I1, I2, I3 in the circuit. The circuit is given here. You have to find the I1, I2, I3 using this. Here I have derived by using the formula of current division rule. I1, I2 and I3 I have found it. I have derived in last derivation that I have derived for only 2 resistors. Like if there are 2 resistors which is connected in parallel, you can easily derive it by I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Similarly, if you have 2 resistors also, if you have 3 resistors also, I have given the formula. That same formula I have used here. Just go through the last session if you are not clear with the formula. So I1 is equal to I into R2 R3 divided by R1 R2 plus R1 R3 plus R2 R3. So from the diagram, R1 is 25, R2 is 50 and R3 is 10, and total current flowing through the circuit is 10 ampere. I1, I2, I3 are the branch currents which is passing through R1 and R2, R3 resistors respectively. Here I have just substituted all the values. I value is 10 and R1 is 25, R2 is 15 and R3 is 10. So I have just substituted the respective values. So I have simplified it. So once listen, once you have find out the denominator, you no need to find out again and again, because this value is same for all the 3 formula. So now we can, I just show you how the first calculation only. 10 into 15 into 10, 1500, and then 25 into 15, 375, then 25 into 10 is 250, then 15 into 10 is 150. So if you add all this through, then it is 775. If you divide it, 1500 divided by 775, 1.93 ampere. You have find out what is I1 current. Similarly, for I2, I have written the formula as I into R1 into R3 divided by the denominator is same. Then just substitute the values, you are getting some 3.22 ampere. Similarly, for I3, I into R2 into R3 divided by same denominator, so just substitute the value, you are getting 4.83 ampere. So now we have find out what is I1, I2 and I3. For the same problem, you have another method also. Like somebody might be having some doubts in deriving when there is like, if you are having more resistors, then some of the people are having some difficulties in solving this problem by using these equations. For those students, which means they will be clear with the formula when there is only 2 resistors like R1 and R2. For R1 and R2 resistors, it is very easy to derive the formula, like I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. But when it is the number of resistors are increasing, they are getting confused to derive the formula. In that case, they can do one thing, like they can find the equivalent resistance for R2 and R3, and then they will be having only two resistance. That time they can use that same formula which is there for two resistor. It will be easy for those people. So that method also I have given you here. Look here. So you have to just redraw the circuit for these two resistors by deriving an equivalent resistance of 15 ohm resistor and 10 ohm resistor. So you know the formula for two resistors which is connected in parallel. So that here it is mentioned as R dash, or you can mention it as R4 or whatever, which means a different name which is not used here. So it is mentioned as R dash here. This R dash is nothing but 15 and 10 ohm equivalent resistors which is connected in parallel. So 15 ohm is parallel to 10 ohm. So the formula is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. That is your equivalent resistance value when two resistors are connected in parallel. So now we have calculated 15 ohm and 10 ohm which is connected in parallel. So you have got the equivalent resistance is 6 ohm. So you can connect that resistance here. Now R1 resistance is there and R dash resistance is there. R dash is nothing but the equivalent resistance of 15 ohm and 10 ohm resistors which is connected in parallel. So now you can do the I1 and I2, means you can find out what is I1 and what is I2 by using this simplified circuit. But be sure that this is not I2, because this is the equivalent resistance of these two resistors. So we have to name this as different. So I have given I dash. So I1 is same, which is passing through 25 ohm resistor, and here it is I dash which is passing through 6 ohm resistor. Now you know the formula. I1 is equal to I is 10 ampere into R2, here R2 is 6 ohm, divided by R1 plus R2 is equal to, this is the simplified value. You have find out what is I1 now. Similarly for I2, here I2 is I dash. So I dash is equal to I is 10 into R1 is 25 divided by R1 plus R2. Then this is the simplified value of I dash. Now you have find out what is I1 and what is I dash. So be sure that this I dash is not the current of not equal to I2, because this I dash is the incoming current which is going through two branches, because this I dash which we have found is the equivalent current of this two branches which is passing through R2 and R3. Now what we have to do is we have to again reconnect this two branches and just take what is the incoming current which is equal to I dash. I dash is 250 divided by 31 ampere. So this incoming current to I2 and I3 branches 250 by 31, which is the total current over here. Now you can apply the same formula which is having I1 and I2 current. So you can just use the same formula. I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now this is R1, now this is R2. Similarly, I2 is equal to I dash. I dash is this current, this into R3 is 10 divided by R2 plus R3. So simplified value of this. Similarly for I3 value also you can derive. So any method you can do, that is your wish. You can do in which method you are familiar with. Next problem is find the branch current given in the circuits. 6 ampere current is going, total current is 6 ampere, and it is just a it's I1 and I1, I2. It is just going into two branches, I1 and I2. You have to find what is I1 and what is I2. So I have just written the data, R1 equal to 10 ohm, R2 is equal to 15 ohm. So I is equal to 6 ampere. Just apply the current divider rule. I1 is equal to I into R2 by R1 plus R2, I2 is equal to I into R1 by R1 plus R2. Just substitute the values and just obtain what is I1 and I2. That's all, very simple. Next problem, find all the branch current given in the circuit. So here you have to find what is I1 and what is I2 and what is I also. You don't have the value of the total current which is passing through the branches. Instead, you have the voltage values. In this case, it's more simple because the voltage across the 10 ohm resistor is also 20 volt. The voltage across the 15 ohm resistor is also 20 volt because these two resistors are connected in parallel. So when two resistors are connected in parallel, the voltage across all the resistors is equal to the source voltage. So here 20 volt is the source voltage which is across the 10 ohm resistor and which is across the 15 ohm resistor. Now you can easily find out the branch current. So V is equal to I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2 because V is same equal for I1 R1 and I2 R2. This is Ohm's law. Just apply to find out what is I1. 20 is equal to I1 into 10. 20 is equal to I2 into 15. Okay. So you can easily find what is I1 and what is I2. Then you can find the total current. I equal to I1 plus I2. Just add these two values, then you will be obtaining what is I also, total current. Next problem, 28. Find the branch current given in the circuit. Here you have four branches. I1, I2, I3 and I4. Total current is 5 ampere. So same, I am going to use formula. When you are having 4 branches, you can write the branch current I1 equal to I into R2, R3, R4 divided by R1, R2, R3 plus R1, R2, R4 plus R2, R3, R4 plus R3, R4, R1. So this one you have to derive. After deriving this, just use this formula, just substitute the values, you will be getting 2.4 ampere as I1, I2 is 1.2 ampere, I3 is 0.8 ampere, I4 is 0.6 ampere. Once you find the denominator, just substitute the value, no need to find it again and again. Only this value is going to vary according to the I1, I2, I3. To verify whether you have find out the branch currents correct, you can just add and check it. All the current I1, I2, I3, I4, you should get the total current of the network. This is the 5 ampere. So if you are getting the same value, then it's very easy and you can easily understand the total current of the network is equal to the sum of all the branch currents. So hope we have seen enough number of problems in current divider rule, voltage divider rule, then Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltages law, voltage law. So I hope we can go to the next topic. Thank you.